So the next terminology in genetics is monohybrid cross. So monohybrid cross refers to a cross between two of a species made to study inheritance of a pair of alleles of a character. Which means in case of a monohybrid cross, what we generally do is, as you see, the word mono means a single. Okay, na? And hybrid refers to that as a pair of the alleles. So, in case of monohybrid cross, we generally take a character, a single character. Either it may be the height of the plant, or it may be the color of the pod, shape of the seed, or color of the flower, okay, or position of the flower or the fruit. So, any one character is being considered. So, when we are considering only one character, which is being regulated by a pair of alleles, then it is being regarded as monohybrid, a cross. A cross made between two of a species made to study inheritance of a pair of alleles. Inheritance of a pair of alleles of a character. So that is being regarded as monohybrid cross. Next is monohybrid ratio. The ratio which is being obtained in the F2 generation of a monohybrid cross that is made, and the offspring of the F1 generation are being self-bred. Which means whenever we take, for example, when we cross a homozygous tall with that of a homozygous dwarf. So what we obtain in the F1 generation is a capital T small t, which is generally hybrid, where there are presence of the heterozygous condition, where one dominant allele is there and the other one is recessive allele. So thereafter, when we self breed, okay, now when the selfing is being done, okay, thereafter whatever we get in the F2 generation, so that ratio what we obtain in the F2 generation, so that is called as a monohybrid ratio. So in case of this monohybrid ratio, what you can see is the phenotypic ratio which will be observed will be 3:1, which means if you look after, so capital D, capital T, capital T, small t, capital T, small t, and the last one is small t, small t. So these are the four individuals which will be seen at the F2 generation in a monohybrid cross. So what we can see here is capital T, capital T, capital T small t and capital T small t represents a tall, and one is with the two recessive alleles, so that is a dwarf. So here the phenotypic ratio when we take, it is 3:1, where 3 are the tall individuals and 1 is the dwarf individual. So that is phenotypic ratio. Meanwhile, genotypic ratio, if we look after, you can see here the two dominant alleles when they are present, okay, so that is representing the homozygous tall, so that is 1. And thereafter, there are presence of 2 heterozygous tall, so that is 2. And the one which is there in a recessive condition, so that is 1. So that is a genotypic ratio is 1:2, 2:1. So that is monohybrid ratio, what we obtain in the F2 generation when the F1 generation is being self-crossed or self-hybridized. Next is dihybrid cross. A cross which is made between two organisms of the same species to study the inheritance of two pairs of alleles, or you can say it as the two genes. Which means in a dihybrid cross, we select two characters. For example, round yellow seeds are being crossed with wrinkled green seeds. Round and yellow. Where round is the shape of the seed. So that is one character, and yellow is the color of the seed, which is another character. So in the dihybrid cross, we generally take two characters. Okay. And when the cross is being made, that is what is called as a dihybrid cross, which includes two pair of alleles. For example, round, so this is for the shape of the seed, which is dominant, and yellow is for the color of the seed, which is again dominant. So that is being crossed with a small rr, small yy. So here also the small rr which is there, that is for the shape of the seed, that is wrinkled, and small yy represents the shape of the seed, which is the color of the seed, which is green. So that is two characters are being taken, okay, and that cross is being called as dihybrid cross. Okay, so you can see here two pairs of alleles. So here this is one pair and this is the other pair. So two pairs of alleles when they are being involved in a cross, so that is called as a dihybrid cross. Next is dihybrid ratio. So the ratio which is being obtained in the F2 generation when a dihybrid cross is made and the offsprings of the F1 generation are being self-bred. Offsprings of the F1 generation are self-bred. So as similar in a monohybrid ratio, however we got, similarly in case of a dihybrid ratio, we take the F1 generation. So for example, if I take here, when the round yellow seeds are crossed with wrinkled green seeds, okay, so in the F1 generation, what we get is capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. So when the selfing is being done, okay, so that is capital R, capital Y, small y. So when the selfing is being done, at the end of the F2 generation, we get a phenotypic ratio, that is 9:3:3:1, where 9 are round yellow seeds, 3 are the round green, next 3 are the wrinkled yellow, and 1 is the wrinkled green. So this is the ratio what we get. So regarding either it may be a monohybrid cross or a dihybrid cross, we will discuss in detail in the next aspects of the principles of inheritance. So remember phenotypic ratio, that is 9:3:3:1. So that is the ratio which is being obtained when we make the dihybrid cross or the F1 generation when they are being self-bred. Next is a test cross. Test cross is a cross which is being generally made between the F1 generation with that of the homozygous recessive parent. So a cross made between a F1 generation or F2 generation, or you can even say unknown genotype with the homozygous recessive parent. So that is what we get is the test cross. So in case of the test cross, what is the need why we have to conduct the test cross? That is necessary to identify the genotype of the F1 generation, which means whether the F1 generation individuals are homozygous in nature or they are heterozygous in nature. But in general, what we know is whenever the two homozygous parents are being crossed, what we obtain in the F1 generation will be always heterozygous in condition. But in some of the cases, homozygous possibilities are also seen, right? So that is to identify the genotype of the F1, whether it is in homozygous or heterozygous condition, we go for the test cross. Okay, so we'll discuss about the test cross and back crosses in the next videos. Back cross, the cross which is being made between the F1 generation with either the homozygous recessive parent or homozygous dominant parent. Understanding? Test cross is made where the F1 generation is being crossed with homozygous recessive parent. So that gives you the test cross. But a back cross is either you can cross the F1 generation with the homozygous dominant parent or homozygous recessive parent. So that is why we call that a test cross, okay, is a back cross, but a back cross is not a test cross. So this particular line is very important for you, which can be asked in case of the CET or it may be in the NEET in the form of a statement. Statement A, statement B, or statement 1 or statement 2. Or it can be even asked as in the form of assertion or reasoning. Every test cross is a back cross, and every back cross is not a test cross, because back cross includes both crossing of the F1 generation with homozygous dominant or homozygous recessive. But a test cross, okay, it only involves crossing of the F1 generation with a homozygous recessive parent. So that is the statement explanation. Now, what is the use of a back cross? Back cross is necessary to increase the particular trait which is being present in that of the parent. Means among the two parents, if some of the parent is having a very good character, and what we want is that particular character is to be seen in that of the next generation. In such cases, we can go for the back crosses. So that is necessary to increase the particular trait of the parent. So generally, this back cross is being used in case of the plant breeding methods. Next is a reciprocal cross. So reciprocal cross is a second cross of the same genotype in which the sexes of the parental generation are being reversed. Which means, when we take, for initially if I take capital AA, for any example, if I take AA and this is AA, where here homozygous dominant I have taken as a female, and homozygous recessive I have taken as a male. Okay, so what we have to do is that cross which can be made, we are interchanging the sexes, which means capital AA becomes a male. We are selecting capital AA as a male and small AA as a female. So when the sexes are being reversed, so that gives us the reciprocal cross. And here that is the second cross, because already we have done, this is the first cross, where we have taken capital AA as female and small AA as male. So this crossing becomes the first cross. But when the second cross, when we interchange the sexes, when we do the second cross, so whatever we obtain, so that will be the reciprocal cross. Next is gene pool. Gene pool is the aggregate of all the genes and their alleles in an interbreeding population. So that is called as a gene pool. The total number of genes and its alleles which are being present in an interbreeding population, so that is called as gene pool. And the last one is the genome. Genome refers to the complete set of the DNA, okay, including all of its genes. So that complete set of the DNA which is being present in an individual or a population, which includes all of its genes, so that is said to be a genome. For example, in case of the Human Genome Project, whatever we have done, so it states that around 25,000 to 30,000 genes are being present, right? So that is a genome. So every organism, either it may be the C. elegans or it may be the Drosophila or any other species which are being studied as a research model, so they have a particular genome. So that is about the genome. So these are the terminologies of the genetics which are being used. Thank you.